And today we're going to talk about AC and DC coupling. And we got a signal that we're going to try and measure here. What type of signal is this, Tom?
This is a AC signal.
It's AC because it's fluctuating around, right?
Yep, fluctuating around on the zero.
We have this hooked up to a signal generator, right? And if we wanted to see a DC component on this signal, what would you do there?
All we have to do is go to the DC offset dial on our signal generator and move
Ooh,
it.
look at that. It's like rising up. Wow. So you've added a DC offset onto this signal. It's no longer centered around zero. And in fact, I can right click here and I can put on a double Y cursor and we could kind of get an idea of how much that DC offset is. Looks like it's all about 0.6 or maybe a little less volts or so. So you added a DC offset. So this signal really has two components, an offset plus the AC. Can we even do
Yeah.
something on the AC? Like
Yes,
you
we
can
can.
change.
I can change the amplitude right here, and it'll change the amount that the signal fluctuates.
Okay, so you could even eliminate that. Now, when we go to measure the signal, there's a coupling field on the channel, and that can tell us whether we can see the DC or the AC component. I'll go to channel setup here, and we can see that, in fact, we have this signal. Is it teed into our system?
Yes, it is.
So we got a splitter coming out of the signal generator, and it's going into two different channels on our front end. And they're both were set to DC coupled, but I'm going to switch one of these to AC coupling. So we got the same signal coming in, and it has both an AC and a DC portion, and one is going to be AC coupled and one's going to be DC coupled. Let's see what happens to our signal. So, wow. So we got one of the signals with the DC coupling still sees the DC offset and the fluctuating component, the AC, right? And then what happened to the green one, Tom?
So the green one's only measuring AC, so it doesn't measure the offset, which is the DC component of it. It only measures the amplitude.
So there's actually an offset on the green channel, but we can't see it because we set the mode to AC coupled.
Correct.
Huh, interesting. I guess this might apply to accelerometers. When I measure an accelerometer, sometimes I measure the vibration of things. Well, let's see. You got an accelerometer hooked up
Yes,
here?
we do, right here.
Okay.
This is what's called a DC accelerometer.
So we have a DC accelerometer hooked up. And right now, it looks like it's measuring about 1G. Why is it measuring 1G? It's not even moving.
It's measuring the gravity.
Oh, yeah. So what happens if you flip that upside down?
So if I flip it, you can see that it flips it to negative one.
Oh. So now instead of things floating down, now they would float up or something.
Yeah, sounds right.
Okay. We're able to measure the DC offset, and I saw as you were like kind of pounding there that we could see the AC stuff too.
Yeah,
Yeah, so
so
we
we
could
can.
see both the AC and the DC. If I go and look at the channel setup, it's set to voltage DC. Let's flip it to voltage AC and see what happens. Now when I go to measure, am I going to see that gravity offset?
You will not.
Let's see what it reads. Wow, we've eliminated gravity. Cool. But we can still see AC vibration?
Yes, we can.
Cool. AC coupling gets rid of any kind of DC offset. But if you have DC coupling, you can actually see both an AC and DC portion of
Correct.
the signal. Cool. Thanks, Tom.
Yep, no problem.